Summary of a Moveable Feast by Ernest Hemingway. In the beginning of the book, Hemingway talks about how the winter in Paris has bad weather and how the cafes are always packed with drunk people. He goes to work in a cafe, where he meets a beautiful woman. He looks at the woman, and seeing her makes him want to write. After that, he goes home and plans a trip for himself and his wife, Hadley. When they get back to Paris, the weather is nice, but it's still cold, and Hemingway is always hungry. When he can't write, he tells himself to write one true sentence and the rest will come. He often goes to see Gertrude Stein at her home with her partner, Alice B. Toklas, at 27 Rue de Fleurus. Hemingway looks up to Stein as a guide, and Stein gives him advice on writing, getting art, and other things. She is a very important person in the artistic and literary worlds of Paris. Hemingway says that they have different ideas about sexuality, which is because Hemingway is more strict in this area. Hemingway can't afford to buy books while he's in Paris, but Sylvia Beach lets him join the renting library of her English language bookstore, Shakespeare and Company, at a discount. Hemingway sometimes sees James Joyce eating at the expensive restaurant Michaud's with his wife Nora and their two children, but he can't afford to go there himself. Hemingway likes walking from his flat to the River Seine, where he can see people selling books and fishermen getting goujon fish. He says that after winter, the weather in Paris sometimes gets better, but then it gets cold and rainy again. He thinks this false spring is truly sad and scary. Hemingway buys a newspaper about horse racing one morning and plans to go to the races. At first, Hadley worries that they don't have enough money to bet, but in the end, they pack snacks and a bottle of wine and have a fun day. In the end, they win, and with the money, they use it to buy champagne and eat at Michaud's. They keep betting at the races, but Hemingway starts to worry that going racing is making their lives harder. He has lunch with Mike Ward, who tells him that he should stop running races. Hemingway often spends the afternoons at 27 Rue de Fleurus, where he and Stein talk about people, books, and other things. Stein doesn't like the kinds of books that Hemingway likes, and she doesn't like many of the writers that Hemingway likes, like Ezra Pound and James Joyce. When Stein's car breaks down, she takes it to the garage, but when the mechanic tries to fix it, she is unhappy. The owner of the shop says that the worker is from a generation perdue or lost generation. Stein agrees, saying that men of Hemingway's age who served in the war became more cynical and more likely to drink too much. During his time in Paris, Hemingway is poor and sometimes has to go without food. This can be hard to do because Paris is full of cafes and bakeries that smell wonderful. But he also finds that hunger sharpens his senses and makes it easier for him to focus on drawings. Sylvia tells him that he needs to eat and not work too hard. After this talk, Hemingway feels ashamed and calls himself a dirty phony saint and martyr. Hemingway lives near the Closerie de Lilas Café, where he sees writers like Blaise Cendres from time to time. Hemingway runs into Ford Madox Ford there one day. Hemingway tries to stay away from Ford because he smells bad and talks in a way that makes no sense. Hemingway has trouble believing that the man in front of him is really the famous writer Ford. One spring evening, Hemingway goes to the Dome to meet the painter Passon. Passon is with his two sisters, whom he talks to in a flirty and somewhat condescending way. Hemingway says that Ezra is a friend who gives a lot. The works in Ezra's studio are all by Japanese artists with long hair. Hemingway likes the men's hair, but he doesn't understand their paintings. On the other hand, Hemingway likes Ezra's wife Dorothy's art. Hemingway shows Ezra how to box at Ezra's studio, where he also meets the painter Wyndham Lewis. Gertrude Stein calls Lewis the measuring worm because he is mean and makes her cringe. After being close friends for many years, Hemingway and Stein's friendship ends suddenly when Hemingway overhears a private exchange between Stein and Alice. Hemingway meets the artist Ernest Walsh at Ezra's studio. Walsh is with two women in mink coats. Hemingway is told by the women that Walsh makes a lot of money from his poems. Later, Walsh tells Hemingway that he is giving him a prize and asks him to a fancy lunch. Hemingway finds out later that Walsh said the same thing to many other writers, including Ezra and James Joyce. Hemingway reads books by Russian authors like Turgenev, Gogol, Tolstoy, and Chekhov from the library at Shakespeare & Company. At the Lillis, he meets the artist Evan Shipman, and they drink whiskey and talk about Dostoevsky and Tolstoy. Even though they tell Jean they don't want any more booze, he keeps bringing it to them. Ezra gives Hemingway a jar of heroin to give to Ralph Cheever Dunning, an artist who is addicted to opiates. Ezra tells Hemingway to save it for an emergency. One day, Ezra calls Hemingway because he thinks Dunning is about to die. When Hemingway tries to give Dunning the opium, Dunning screams at him and throws it back. Hemingway thinks that Dunning might have thought that he was an agent of evil. Hemingway and Hadley start to spend the winters in Austria after Bumby is born. There, they go skiing with Walther Lent, who is known as the pioneer of high mountain skiing. In Austria, they have a wonderful time. They eat great food, read books from Shakespeare and Company, and Hemingway finishes making changes to the first draft of The Sun Also Rises. Several snowboarders die in avalanches one winter, but Hemingway says that this disaster doesn't compare to the mental disaster that starts the end of his marriage to Hadley the next year. Hemingway talks about Scott Fitzgerald and says that he has beautiful traits that are a bit feminine. At the Dingo Bar, Hemingway meets Scott and the pitcher Dunk Chaplin. Scott compliments Hemingway's work, which makes him both happy and embarrassed. Scott asks Hemingway to go with him to Lyon to pick up the car he and Zelda left there. Scott isn't at the train stop when Hemingway arrives, and the two don't meet until the day after Hemingway comes in Lyon. During the trip, Scott acts like a drama queen and a hypochondriac, telling Hemingway that he is about to die and making him take care of him. Scott thinks about Zelda all the time, and after calling her, he won't eat anything. Scott gives Hemingway a copy of The Great Gatsby when they go back to Paris. Hemingway reads it and loves it. He asks Hemingway and Hadley over to his place for lunch. Hemingway is sure that Zelda is going to keep Scott from working later because she has a bad hangover. Hemingway sees that Scott is often rude to his inferiors, and that Scott gets angry when Hemingway doesn't show him a draft of The Sun Also Rises. After Zelda has a nervous breakdown, Scott and Hemingway go to Michaud's for lunch, and Scott tells Hemingway that Zelda has made him doubt the size of his penis. Scott is checked out by Hemingway, who tells him he is fine and warns him that Zelda wants to destroy him. When Hemingway works in cafes, sometimes other people come in and talk to him. A young man bothers Hemingway while he works one day. They have an angry, but fun, talk, and Hemingway says he hopes the young man will become a famous reviewer when he grows up. However, this doesn't happen. Ezra is always helping other people. One day, he and Natalie Clifford Barney start a project to raise money so that T.S. Eliot can quit his day job at the bank. After The Wasteland comes out, though, it's clear that Eliot no longer needs financial help, so the effort ends before it should. Hemingway decided to let his hair grow long after seeing how Ezra's Japanese friends did it. He knows that other people will think he is damned, but he says that he and Hadley like being seen as damned together. One of the easy secret pleasures of their life together is this. In Austria, the hotel owner tells Hemingway that his long hair is a revolt against the years of war and gives him a plant medicine to help his hair grow faster. Hemingway is in charge of looking after Larry Gaines, a black Canadian boxer who comes to Paris to fight at the Stade Anastasie, a dance hall restaurant that is sometimes used as a boxing ring. Larry does well in the fight and wins. Hemingway and Hadley leave Bumby with a maid and her husband, Tootin, during the summer. Tootin teaches Bumby a lot of French habits and sayings, which Bumby says over and over again, making Hemingway and his friends laugh. Bumby worries about Scott because he can tell that Scott has problems with drinking and his mind. Hemingway and Pauline go to a Princeton football game with Scott, Zelda, and Henry Mike Strader when they get back to the United States. Scott and Zelda act in a stupid and dangerous way, leaving Hemingway and Mike to try to fix the damage they caused. Hemingway talks about a winter in Austria when the rich come to the hotel with their pilot fish. During this winter, Pauline comes into Hemingway and Hadley's lives, and Hemingway talks about how sad he is about how his marriage to Hadley ends. Hemingway talks about Evan Shipman going to Cuba while he is sick with pancreatic cancer in the last part of the book. Evan tells Hemingway that it's important for him to write down his thoughts of Paris, saying, "You write for all of us."
About the author. Ernest Hemingway was born in Oak Park, Illinois, the second of Clarence and Grace Hemingway's six children. Clarence Hemingway took Ernest camping and shooting with him a lot in rural Michigan. This made Ernest love the woods for the rest of his life. Hemingway played boxing and football in high school, and he also liked to write short stories for the school paper and magazine. During World War I, Hemingway joined the Red Cross in 1918 and was sent to the Italian front. He was badly hurt, so he spent the rest of the war in Milan getting better before going back to the United States. Hemingway spent most of the 1920s in Paris, where he met a group of writers called the Lost Generation by the author Gertrude Stein. When In Our Time, a collection of short stories by Hemingway, came out in 1925, he became famous almost right away. His popularity grew even more when his first book, The Sun Also Rises, came out in 1926. Hemingway was known for having a complicated love life. He divorced his first wife, Hadley, for his mistress, Pauline. A few years later, he met a journalist named Martha Gellhorn and divorced Pauline. After falling in love with Mary Welsh, he divorced Martha and stayed married to her until he died. Hemingway was famous and wealthy for many years, but his fast-paced, dangerous lifestyle and poor physical and mental health started to hurt his work and personal life. In 1961, Hemingway killed himself in Ketchum, Idaho, where he lived alone. Hemingway wrote two non-fiction books and seven collections of short stories over the course of his life. After his death, more of his works, like The Garden of Eden and A Moveable Feast, were released.
Hope we summarized it fully and you liked it. Please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so that we are motivated to create more videos.